Your girl Chris back at you with another one. If you're new to the channel, man, go ahead and subscribe. Leave me some comments in the comment section. Ring the notification bell. Hit me up on Twitter. Of course, if you like the video, go ahead and leave me a thumbs up. And man, oh man, SummerSlam is next week. Next week, and the build for the Roman Reigns John Cena match has been pretty. It's been alright up until this point. See, SmackDown is going on tonight. It kicked off with a promo between John Cena and Roman Reigns, and I'm gonna go ahead and be honest with you guys, this is pretty much everything I wanted and then some. You got two top superstars going back and forth, telling us off the top of the dome, unscripted, I guess, just totally them, 100% them and all that. So man, of course, you already know how to come with a reaction for you guys, reaction to the segment. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Let's get into this reaction. Let's go.
The waltz is around here thinking that this is your show. Thinking that we all have to play by your rules. Thinking that this is your company. Everybody knows it belongs to them.
It kind of is.
Yeah, I know how you feel. You want to throw up in your mouth a little bit because you're sick about that, because you're so far above everyone else. That's why I'm back, dude. I'm the only one that can shut you up. Because you see, the WWE has been pushing you for a decade now, failure after failure after failure after failure, and you're still here because you're the best chance they got. And you built such a layer of protection over yourself that no other WWE superstar even has a chance in there with you. That's where I come in. They asked me to come back. They asked me to come back because, you know, big old piece of humble pie, and you're going to get one when I beat your ass at SummerSlam.
Humble pie on the menu, says John Cena.
Humble pie on the menu.
You see, Roman, they know, it's starting to build. They know they got 1 week left to choose. It's either going to be Team Reigns.
I'm Team Reigns. I'm rocking with the Chief.
Or Team Cena, but it will. Tulsa has chosen, and you're sitting at a very small table right now because SummerSlam is going to be history. You can count on that.
Roman's like, are you done? Are you done?
I told you it's their show.
I thought we were going to get something original here. I thought we were going to get something fresh. You come out here, you make D jokes. Penis jokes.
Oh yeah, he did make D
you
jokes.
The same stuff.
Start off his promo.
I heard that before. Come on, John, give me something good. Cut me. Hit me with some good stuff here, John.
I'm going to. I'm not going to beat your ass, Roman. Roman Reigns is going to beat my ass at SummerSlam. Oh, yeah. He's going to beat my ass real good.
Right now.
Spear. Big punch named after another DC superhero. Big punch named after another DC superhero. Hype man.
It's funny because he was in
the
DC movie.
Holding up the championship. You're going to kick my ass at SummerSlam. I don't need to prove myself to you, Roman. That's what's so historic about what's going on. I just need to pin you. One, two, three. You see, if I could hold on to that just one more time, that'd make it the 17th championship for me.
No, you're not big on that. You're a Ric Flair guy.
Achievement that would make me the most decorated champion of all time. That match would make history. All I need to do that is one, two, three. As fun as that would be for me, it's really all about you. I'm here to help you, Roman. I'm here to help you.
That's how good he is. He's here to help me.
Yeah, he's going to help the chief. That's what's up.
He's here to help the tribal chief, the head of the table.
What a great guy John Cena is. He's going to help Roman.
I'm not going to bury my opponent and then go out there and say I'm going to beat a bum. No, John, I respect you. I do things differently around here. I'm sophisticated. We do a compelling storytelling here, John.
Long-term storytelling, pal.
Arguably the greatest of all time. Underappreciated. Not enough respect on this man's name. You've done things that nobody else has ever done before. On the cusp of 17-time world heavyweight champion. Nobody else can say that. It's incredible, man. You're the best. Mount Rushmore WWE, you might take every slot. I'm just proud to say that I could beat John Cena. That's how good you are.
Again, and I like the way they're no-selling the fact that these two wrestled before.
In WWE at the same time, I mean,
we're just going to ignore that. That didn't even happen.
We don't have enough time on SmackDown to promote all your movies. Hey, what, you got like 4 movies out right now, John? You're good, man. Your career says it. It's on the wall. You're good enough to stand in this ring and verbally joust with anybody. That's not my game, man. You're good enough to main event SummerSlam with the Tribal Chief. You're even good enough to win the WWE Championship.
Nope. What if we said the NXT Championship?
But you're not good enough.
The 205 Live Championship.
The Universal Championship.
The 24/7 Championship. Everything except for the Universal Championship.
20 plus years of missionary might have been good enough for you. But it wasn't good enough for Nikki Bella.
Ooh, damn. Got him.
I'm gonna smash you. I'm gonna retain this title.
Yeah, this is the same Roman Reigns for a few years
send
ago.
Send you back to the movie set. Send you back to Hollywood. But I want you to enjoy this.
It's not
this.
That same guy.
Tulsa, this might be the last time that we ever get John Cena again. So take us home, kid.
No problem. You want a compelling story. You want to hypocritically criticize me for saying dick jokes and then bring up sexual positions and a breakup that I've had.
Yeah, we said dick on a PG
you
show.
You haven't been embarrassed. You've been protected. This pretty face, those giant bars
it's like, what are they
going to
do,
for
fire
tea?
Me? That's both of their mindsets. You've got to know that right now.
You've been protected by the Shield. Hell, you almost ruined Seth Rollins. You ran Dean Ambrose out of WWE. You've had...
Damn, he made fun of his teeth and made...
You've had 10
brought up Dean Ambrose.
Whole
good God.
Years, 5 I wonder what WrestleMania happened to Dean main Ambrose. Events. Paul Heyman in your corner. 2 lackeys to do your dirty work. The protection of the system. And it still
and he made
isn't
fun of the man's
working.
Teeth.
You need to be embarrassed. You people want a compelling story at SummerSlam, right?
Yeah, we do. We sure do, John.
You people want to be at the edge of your seat. Wanting to know what's going to happen.
What's going to happen,
right
John?
About so much. SummerSlam will be compelling. I will go to a Hollywood movie set. And you will smash me. But he knows better than anybody how much punishment I can take and never quit. I've been against the odds my whole freaking life. I built Suplex City, and all I need to do is just hang in there. 1, 2, 3. And you're the biggest failure in WWE history. You have to shine. You have to smash and bash and overachieve. All I need is 1, 2, 3. And you're the answer to a trivia question. Who did John Cena beat to become 17-time champion?
That guy that looks like Jason Momoa.
You're gonna show up all full of yourself like you normally do and put on a hell of a show. I'm just gonna hang in there for 1, 2, 3. and then I'm going to take your title. I'm going to jump the barricade, and I'm going to run out of Allegiant Stadium as fast as I can. I may even blow you a kiss goodbye.
Wow, we got dick jokes, John Moxley references, and a CM Punk reference.
It's inevitable.
Oh my God.
No one
all this from a dude who just knows
anymore.
Missionary position.
At SummerSlam, the champ is gone. One, two, three.
My God. My Lord of Mercy, Jesus. Wow, so like I said, we got John Cena making pee-pee jokes, Roman throwing out the missionary, making fun of the whole Nikki Bella thing, John Cena referencing Dean Ambrose, John Moxley, a CM Punk mention kind of sort of inadvertently. Oh my goodness. And all this, this has been the best build for SummerSlam so far. Like, we had good things here and there, but this moment right here, this promo, this segment between John Cena and Roman Reigns, that's it. That's how you talk him in the building. If the match sells itself, yes, but this is what really takes it home. This is what really, this is going to be the thing in the promo package where you see the one, two, three, and the missionary, and the over and over and all that. This is what it's all about. This is how you build to the match, you know what I'm saying? So oh man, yo, I'm just speechless right now, because this really took me back to the old Attitude Era days. This gave me Rock Stone Cold vibes. Oh man. Anyway, man, let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. What did you guys think of this segment? What did you guys think of this promo? What do you guys think? Who do you think is going to win between John Cena and Roman Reigns? Do you think it's going to be Superman punching a spear for the win? Or do you think it's going to be an AA 1, 2, 3? What do you think? Let me know in the comment section below. Of course, as always, like, comment, subscribe. You guys take care. Be easy. I'm out. Peace. Peace. Peace.